My name is Fernando Dominguez. I work at Sandbox AQ as a Vice President of Business Development. For somebody that is not in the AQ field, it's important to understand that our day-to-day is no different from any other organization that is trying to have a positive impact in the world. What we do is we take the tools that artificial intelligence and quantum physics have been developing for the last decades, and we use them to solve our partners' problems. To create a positive impact in the world. So at the end of the day, it's the same thing. We have limited resources and we try to give service to the people that work with us. How I originally joined the AQ field was through working in innovation and technology. Of course, I never expected to work on this field when I started my career 20 years ago. And I did first quantum mechanics in college. Back then it was more a theoretical approach and didn't really understand the applications of it. This was in the early 2000s. The progress of AI in the last 10, 15, 20 years had made that those equations that I studied back then in college have an application today. All my career, my goal has been to work on something that can improve the world and always using technology as a way of making people's lives better. When I was at Google X, I ran into Jack's team and Stefan's team, what was called Sandbox then. And they were using all these new tools that I have never heard of before to try to solve new problems. And I thought that that was a new radical way of doing things. And for the next decade, that's gonna radically transform humanity. For somebody who's discovering the AQ field, my only recommendation would be to try not to be scared of the word quantum. Everything new is scary for humans. We are trying to avoid change. But it's change what makes us progress and move forward. So same as I did, I'm not a physicist. I am an engineer that developed its career mostly on the business and partnership sides. And we have many people at Sandbox that are not physicists and that can work on the AI and quantum field. It's very important as adults that we continue learning and developing ourselves. So anybody that is discovering this field, I'll say, just keep on reading about it, be curious, and try to see how these new tools can help you solve your problems. So to stay up to date on this rapidly moving ecosystem, it's important to be curious. It's the same thing that has been happening over and over again for the last decades. Every 2 to 5 years, there's a new technology that is coming up. If you can do an analogy with the beginning of the internet, for example, when we first started using the internet, we had no idea what it was for. And if you remember how you were trying to get into it and trying to load your first website, it was barely working and you did not really understand how it worked. It happened the same thing with the cloud and it happened the same thing with every new age of technology. Quantum and AQ is not going to be different. At the beginning, it takes a little bit of time to really understand the implications of it, but the more you're curious, the more you read, the more you learn, the more you're going to be able to make the connections between the things that you're working on and how the AQ tools can help you solve those problems. There are multiple risks that we take through our career and it's important. That's a factor that we like a lot and we share as DNA and part of the DNA of the company as employees. People that have taken some risks somehow to develop themselves or to move forward in their careers. I can think of one of the first risks that I've taken in my career was one of the first job offers that I had was to work for a bank in Europe. And I decided to decline that, which was a very comfortable career path because I wanted to achieve two things. I wanted to go abroad because I always thought that going abroad, working in a different culture, in a different continent, helps you develop many more skills and aptitudes. And you have to learn a new language many times and a new culture, how to work with them. I took a different kind of contract that was only a 3-month internship contract in a different industry, in a different continent, and just took one-way flight to Mexico City, a city or a country that I had never been before. And that was very risky at the time. Everybody was telling me around, what are you doing? Why are you going over there? And it ended up being some of the best decisions in my life because I ended up then joining Google through the Mexico growth. So what is seen as a risk many times, it's a risk because others are not taking that path. And the fact that others are not taking that path is probably going to bring you more rewards in the future.